Sometimes, when a new pack's announced and I see the trailer, it gets me excited about something new coming to Sims 4. How could I help it? I mean, you see how amazing that looks. Trailers have these incredible transitions, quick cuts to the action, and the upbeat music. It seems like great things are coming. It's total brain candy. But sometimes, those features turn out to be a fantasy you can only experience while watching the trailer. Nowhere near as great as they seem. My betrayed expectations shatter, and I take one more step on the lonely road to cynicism. An open question to you folks is, what got you really excited that turned out to be a major letdown? Everybody knows the first big expectation that gets ruined in the lead up to Realm of Magic, but we'll also take a look at it from another angle. The expectation is, these sages were the ones we were supposed to get and they look awesome. While we got one of them, they decided to do a switcheroo for whatever reason. These are the sages you learn magic from, and the Sims community found this to be a fine meme-making opportunity. Meanwhile, one of them is modeled after a Maxis employee, which is somewhat awkward for anyone who may or may not have said he looks like he stinks. Okay, it was me, but I was mostly talking about the clothes. I still cringe though. Another less talked about thing is this, the lore. Now, I'm fine with just a backstory, but this expectation was actually in the trailer.
A swirling vortex threatens to tear the realm apart. The only thing keeping it together? A balance between the three houses of magic. Specialize in one, or bring balance to the realm and master them all.
Well, after playing it, I can report that this isn't anywhere in this pack. The lore's non-existent, it's just told to you, and I haven't been a fan of pretending since I was a kid. It's cool there is at least an explanation for why this place is this way for your headcanon, but it reeks of missed opportunity. It definitely sounds like there could have been some longer-term quest to change the world and bring it back together by becoming a master in all the schools. Your first impression of Dineout could reasonably be, holy shit, look, there are 16 Sims. Yeah, I know, I counted. But they're all simultaneously eating a meal at one time and no one is standing anywhere they should not be. There is not one place in this whole trailer where someone is not where they should be. Players do not have the ability to get 16 Sims sitting down at one place without mods that stop the AI from thinking stupid thoughts. This happened while I was recording some footage. This celebrity guest walks up to the Goths table, isn't with them, and decides to take their food. After she's done on her phone, after dropping it off, she goes in for a second run, then returns to her now cold meal at her table on the other side of the restaurant. It makes my point for me, as this wasn't originally in the script. You might also think, hey, this is gonna be awesome, I'm gonna make a family-owned business. Nope, you can't do that, no one in your family can work at the restaurant, an extremely unrealistic fact that, with a bit more effort, surely would have been possible to pull off. Make it while they work, they're NPCs, or you could even control them directly. At the same time, I have to compliment this trailer overall.
Hiring a skilled chef can make a restaurant shine.
This one actually has a person explaining what you'll get to do as a player, various benefits you'll unlock, and makes the pack seem good without being completely unreasonable. They set dress almost every shot to be perfect, but at least it's not like the next trailer. This one is big. Let's take a trip down memory lane to the launch of Get Famous and get a big dose of expectations. Look at this beauty. We've got these amazing scenes of an epic pirate battle on a ship. If you think it's unbelievably good, you're correct. It's not believable. Next is this amazing sci-fi chase scene with the Sims barely escaping from the villain. No doubt it would make some gullible earlier version of me think, hey, maybe I could be the villain. So many actors are involved in this scene, it's amazing. And look, it's a bank heist. At this point, we knew Get Famous comes with money vaults, so I know exactly what I'm planning to do. I want my sim to be chased by a group of women, and I want to see what happens when they capture him, and I'm going to steal all their money. It's so well choreographed. I want synchronization in my game and anime, apparently. Sure, I'll take some anime in Sims. Why not? That trailer is one of the flashiest of the Sims 4 era, and it's entirely a work of fiction. None of it is real, and it said it right there at the beginning while you were distracted, you know, watching it. There are money vaults, but the only Sim who has one doesn't have a dollar in it. You can't do a heist. If you put money in it, you could pretend, but no one will be chasing you. And you won't be seeing any movies your Sim is in. See, you've gotta read that fine print. Playing an actor goes a lot more like this, and not at all like this. There are 9 total Sims in this scene in the trailer, but mine only have 2. They just stand at the X and do animations with each other. The reality is that none of that trailer is to be found in the game in any way. It far exceeds the game's capabilities and is not possible. It's just some cool graphics that are totally unrelated to Get Famous and things you probably wish you could do. The other trailer for this one takes its liberties as well, even if it has 1 foot in reality. It doesn't have that disclaimer about gameplay. But we know that Sims never organize in rows. They clump up at the entrance and act really creepy. Also, this limousine scene is absurdly good and was meticulously crafted. Finally, you want to know what's going on behind the camera here? I'll tell you. Sims are playing musical chairs and talking while she gives the speech. I guarantee it. We can also look to the present to find unrealistic expectations. Recently, I took one more cynical step toward loneliness and life devoid of Sims excitement. The trailer for Snowy Escape comes out in October, and it looks like, among other things, you can have a mountain adventure. Sims are shown warming up by the fire and making an epic trek to the top of Mount Comer Abbey, where they will no doubt behave exactly as they always do, but it's about the memories we shared in the journey. Climbing a mountain is a brave adventure and not for the faint of heart or anyone under level 6 rock climbing. The day of release, I built up to going on that mountain adventure. I did some skiing and visited the other neighborhoods, then tried to send my Sim up the mountain. It won't let me go alone. Okay, that's kind of strange since I'm right there ready to go, but hey, they call the shots. When I drag this guy's wife with me, totally unprepared, I figure I'm in for a steep hill to climb. The truth is, there is so much equipment, pea bushes, and even food that spawns up here that you can easily survive with only a tiny amount of preparation. The only way you'll fail is if you try to go at like level 5 because you require 6, a somewhat odd decision to protect everyone from a Sim dying, I guess. Which makes me wonder, why add new deaths? But hey, I walked up the mountain and found a lot you can build on. We made it in record time, but got a silver because we didn't stop to nap. Get to Work's trailers overall are some of the strongest in the Sims 4 era. There are like 11 of them, but you know what they don't do? Use footage that is not created from actual gameplay. They had style and substance and set realistic expectations overall, but this pack itself did subvert expectations in a bad way. While it had a new life state, it would be among the last of the franchise to consistently provide new life states in an expansion. It made its own first in that this was the first expansion I'd ever covered that featured this many traits. Right. 0. It also lacked aspirations and an extremely lackluster world. So it was only adding those active careers and new retail function, but not contributing lots of little things you might use every day because of the narrow focus. That said, the gameplay was there, but expansions started weak in that they did not really expand anything. If you're one of those people who seemingly apologizes for those types of things not being included, consider where Sims 4 would be if each expansion had actually expanded on the traits and aspiration offerings to give Sims new personalities and new goals. Instead, this list has only barely moved despite players throwing record amounts of money at it. At some point, the tone of marketing for Sims 4 shifted gears from being grounded in reality, featuring things you will see when you play the game, and setting realistic expectations, to being perfectly curated scenes where Sims behave in an unrealistic way, like with Dine Out. Other times, it's been marketed in a way that is pure fantasy, like Get Famous. The mature, reality-based trailers of the past are the type I miss most. Sure, the new trailers are flashy, but they're trying to show you a side of the game that does not exist. I'm hoping to look toward the future of Sims soon, so check back for some discussion on that. Thank you for watching.